Well, he's a black Muslim, keep in mind. Yeah, he's a black Muslim.
Yeah. And he thinks the LGBTQ is kind of weird. Let's be honest, a lot of us do. It doesn't mean that we hate anybody, but he thinks it's a little bit odd. That's his greatest crime here. He just made fun of people who chop off their c**ks. You know, there's been so much outrage over this. I watched the special. I encourage everybody to watch the new special.
Yes. Yep. Legendary.
Sticks and Stones is a special.
Very good.
It's had the left in meltdown mode.
Love it.
Over the last week, in case you've missed it.
And if you at home watching this on Netflix, remember, you clicked on my face.
So that's Dave Chappelle promo for his special, which is now available on Netflix, Sticks and Stones. It has been controversial.
I think that Dave Chappelle talking about trans people, it's not Dave Chappelle at his finest, and he doesn't know what he's talking about.
Hey, did you know she used to be a man?
Yeah. No. A totally unbiased opinion pulled on the subject, right?
Yeah. Her at her finest.
Just in case you know, never pull the wool over the eyes on old Steven. Here's the thing. Lost. They're talking about a special called Sticks and Stones. This is what's so funny. Right. It might as well just be called Screw You. If you write a negative review of this because you're offended, you're taking the bait. And they took the bait.
Bait taken.
Yeah. They couldn't resist.
Well, something else that I've noticed, it's a lot easier, and we'll get to the Rotten Tomatoes, the critics' reviews. Right. And I want to actually leave a review below because I'd like to see what you guys think, because we're not all accredited reviewers on Rotten Tomatoes, apparently. Yeah. You know they rejected us not long ago?
Really?
No.
For good reason.
Well, yeah, it's not surprising.
I can see why.
I noticed, though, that there are a lot of the written reviews that you consider negative, but not a lot of video reviews. And the reason for it is they don't want to show clips.
Yeah.
Because if they show the clip to tell you how offensive it is, most people will see the clips and go, well, that's funny!
Exactly.
keep in mind, by the way, Dave Chappelle is explicitly anti-Trump, okay?
Right.
Relatively speaking, gun control, sometimes pro-choice, kind of keeps you guessing. He takes jabs at everybody in this special.
Yeah, okay,
he even headlined a protest against Trump's so-called Muslim ban. I know it's not a Muslim ban, but for the sake of trying to keep this short, I'm going to say that.
Yeah, we'll refer to it as.
So then, why the outrage?
Right.
Basically, it all boils down to the fact that Dave Chappelle jokes about transgenders.
Yeah.
Which should be fair game.
Cancel.
Done. And over.
Oops.
Right away.
Totally done.
And before we get started, we have gotten started, I should say, before we continue. I don't know why I just said before we get started. It's like, what have you been doing this whole time?
Well, leading
longest
up to starting.
Intro.
You're on drugs.
Nope, just me.
He's on drugs.
It's important to note there's a trend amongst a lot of the critics of Chappelle.
Yeah.
Like the Rotten Tomatoes, one of the reviewers, I think we have a screen, Ian Thomas Malone. Transgender.
Mm.
Amanda Carey at The Advocate, transgender.
Mm.
ContraPoints, who's embarrassed, quote for Chappelle, transgender. That's the one who used to be a man.
Yeah.
But
you spotted it. You
now
spotted
a woman.
Yeah.
Now a woman, though.
Good call. Good
woman.
Call.
Used to be, though. Just because I wouldn't want you to cause any offense.
Thank you.
Yes.
Yeah. So that might provide some insight as. And canceled.
And canceled again.
We've been canceled.
Well, that's why it came out on Netflix, so you can't cancel it.
Well, it might give you some insight as to why the reviews are so negative. But we're going to look a little more closely as to how they've covered it. A couple of things that they've done here. This is something you see a lot. The left, they take comedy seriously. Right? They've been reporting on this special. I wouldn't even say
always,
as though it's an op-ed in a newspaper. They've been covering it like it's a news article in a newspaper.
Yeah.
Like, not even the op-ed section of Fox News. Like, not even Hannity or Carlson. They're acting like it's Shep Smith.
Yeah.
Straight down the middle.
And the thing is, they've called him a woman-hating transphobe from this special.
On?
These jokes are really obvious. And something Jim Norton talks about, and I think this is important to kind of keep in mind, why is there no pass for comedians? For some reason, there used to be more of a pass for hip-hop artists, a little bit less now, except for Lil Nas X, who came out as gay. Who could have possibly seen that one coming?
No.
But they gave it a pass quite a bit. You know, someone can go out and sing about gangbanging and bitches and hoes and selling crack. And they didn't have a problem with Ludacris or Jay-Z, right? It was about free speech. But then comedians, if they tell a joke, it's meant to be taken entirely seriously.
Right.
Whereas really, it's the art form that is supposed to have the most amount of leeway with someone being facetious or sarcastic.
It's like a jester.
Absolutely. Right. It should be the last safe haven for free speech in this country. And yet, it's not.
Well, and he spends a lot of time mocking white people. And you know what?
He does.
And I don't want to go where the identitarians do, like, well, that's why is that okay? Because it's a white genocide. No, I think it's funny. When a black man does the basic white guy voice, I'm like,
it is kind of funny.
I have an uncle who sounds like that.
Yeah.
All of them do.
And none of us can jump. And here's another thing that they claim. They claim that Dave Chappelle is punching down, right? This is why they're so upset. And this is really typical of the left because we've talked about this. Their worldview is predicated on idea of societal structure, of classes, of oppression. And by the way, granting the automatic moral high ground,
to whoever they view as the underdog. That's why they support Palestine over Israel, even though they kill children and they target them deliberately. That's why they support people, Antifa. AOC raises money for Antifa, even though they had weapons and they were attacking cops. So they just see you, if you're the underdog, if you have less power, then you must be inherently morally right. So in this case, they argue that Chappelle is a bully because he's punching down at transgenders. And lest you think I make this up, I hate that we have to do this.
Oh, boy.
Clip from the Young Turks thing.
Like, you're doing it to be funny and to joke, but a lot of people who are saying similar things are not doing it for that reason.
What?
So no more jokes.
That would be less relevant. So this is what's important, is Dave Chappelle in his special, if you haven't watched it, he clearly demonstrates that the LGBTQ, as he refers to as alphabet people, they are in power.
Right.
And he does, and he undergirds this with some very funny bits. He talks about how he wasn't allowed to say a on the Chappelle show, and he realized that he'd written an unwritten rule in Hollywood, right? Again, he talks about the alphabet people. He's not punching down at all. He's punching up. This is what's important to know.
Yeah,
if you need any more proof, is there any, case in point, is there any more powerful, you know this, Half-Asian Bill, because we have some legal documents at some point here. Is there any more powerful organization out there that you can think of outside of Google, YouTube? I mean, maybe Facebook, but they're up there, right? When we're talking about corporate overlords, for some reason, when it's convenient for the left, they often don't mention Google and YouTube.
Exactly.
But let's assume they're powerful. Let's say not number one, because I don't want to use an extreme example to make a point. I don't want to engage in hyperbole here.
Don't do it.
Because you might fact check me.
Like, actually, Amazon is worth more, and if you look at the...
I'm sorry!
What are they shipping those?
I'm sorry, I was shooting from the hip. I didn't realize you were going to fact-check a joke. here you go. CEO of YouTube, look at her cowering before the LGBTQAAIP alphabet community.
The decision that we made was very hurtful to the LGBTQ community. Really sorry about that.
I'm really personally very sorry, and it was not our intent. We'll speak to people from the LGBTQ community, make sure that we're incorporating that going forward in terms of how we think about
it.
I am truly, truly sorry for the hurt that we caused that community. I really do apologize for the hurt that we caused.
That's harder to watch than Maggie Gyllenhaal. So,
correct though.
Yeah. You know what?
Extreme,
again, hyperbole.
But correct.
Not exactly. But she does a gross disservice to the International Clint Howard Lookalike Foundation. I just want to make sure that
everyone,
she does not speak for all of them.
Very clear.
Think about this for a second. All. The world's most powerful big tech organizations shudder in fear at the mere thought of a video suggesting that hormone replacement therapy for six-year-olds could be unhealthy and that it might be found to be trending. Yeah. That's what she's talking about. She's talking about this channel, by the way. And this is the entire purpose of comedy. I think a lot of people miss this. The whole purpose of comedy as an art form is to speak truth to power, is to poke your finger like your Rahm Emanuel in the shower in the chest of the person who has authority. The court jester was the only person allowed to mock the king at all.
Yep. Yeah,
that's
absolutely
what it's designed to do. That's what Dave Chappelle was doing. And then these same people out there say, well, listen, how dare you bully? And he goes, well, hold on a second. I think you're the bully. Silence!
Exactly.
Right.
Well, he's a black Muslim, keep in mind. Yep, he's a black Muslim. Yeah.
And he made fun
of... And he thinks the LGBTQ... It's kind of weird. And let's be honest, a lot of us do. It doesn't mean that we hate anybody, but he thinks it's a little bit odd. That's what he talks about. That's his greatest crime here. Yeah. A black Muslim comedian who has largely shaped black American culture for our generation. He's effectively this generation's Eddie Murphy or Richard Pryor.
Yeah, yeah.
It would be tough to argue against that. He just made fun of people who chop off their c***s.
That's not a stretch.
Didn't say he hated them. He said that's kind of funny. All right. Speaking of which, notification bell, hit it if you're subscribed, because apparently subscriptions don't mean anything. Or just bookmark the page. You can check back every single day.
That's safe.
Join up MugClub, letterscar.com/MugClub. You get Dave Rubin now. He's going to be here at the Blaze when the show launches. We will give you the exact, it's pretty soon. I don't know the exact date.
Yeah.
And subscribe on iTunes. Here's another thing that they claim to, the left in handling this. And I want to see if you disagree with anything that we're talking about here, because I understand this is a little more nuanced. I hate using that word, but it is here.
It's a good word.
They're also saying, the left are saying, that because Chappelle said these things in this special, it must mean that cancel culture is just a figment of your imagination.
It feels like a lot of comedians reach that point where all they want to talk about is the stuff that they're not allowed to talk about that they always talk about.
Yes.
They're not allowed to, even though they do all the time.
It's almost as though that's a comedian's job.
Maybe.
Can you imagine saying this about Lenny Bruce? It seems to me, by the way, he's straight. It seems to me that Lenny Bruce just wants to go upstage and, like,
point, shine a light on societal taboos.
Well, this is important to note is yes, Chappelle pulls this off because he's already extremely famous. But yeah, as he points out in his special, famous people aren't immune. It's easier for them, but look at Kevin Hart. Kevin Hart was banned from hosting the Oscars because he effectively tweeted a gay joke. Now, if he's not actually Kevin Hart, you know what happens? He's not banned from the Oscars. He's banned from speaking at clubs, from performing at comedy clubs. He's banned from speaking at colleges. So they have a little bit more leeway, but they're not completely immune. And by the way, famous people, they have their reputations destroyed for far less. So here's something else to keep in mind. Chappelle, his clip from Netflix, where he was talking about Jussie Smollett, spoiler alert for people who haven't seen it.
Jussie Smollett.
It was trending, number two on YouTube, with unbleeped, use the word and he'd say the N-word. He would say the N-word a lot. So he said, so repeatedly he said in this, and it was unbleeped, and I can't even say you want, see, just you're hearing the beep. I'm saying the actual word. So he said, and I don't even want to say the word. I'm not going to say the other one because then I'll not only I'll get banned, there's going to be a summit, there's going to be a march. Yes. So I don't want to say the word.
I'll be at the front of that march.
Just a quarter of you, though.
You know who will be least offended by it? If you repeated Dave Chappelle's bit to Dave Chappelle and use the words that he used.
Yeah.
Yeah. 100% that's fine.
He would laugh.
Now, keep in mind, so he was allowed to make those comments because he's famous. There's so many ways. Our channel was nearly banned just for having the word figs on a shirt. So, if you need more evidence, by the way, cancel culture is real. ContraPoints, the transgender, used to be a man, by the way. Right there, you just watched bashing Chappelle on the Young Turks. Not anymore. Make sure you get it right.
Transgender means?
Make sure you get it right. Not anymore.
Not anymore. From one to another.
It's an easy mistake.
I need to re-review. Can we go back?
It's an easy mistake to make.
It is.
At first glance, you'd be like, so clearly a woman. Now. So, ContraPoints was canceled yesterday for not being woke enough for trans Twitter. There was a cancel culture campaign run against Z, and Z deleted Z's account.
Oh my gosh.
Leftists, they're convinced that Chappelle, this is the argument that they finally use, in case you didn't agree, is that he's just out of touch with the current audience.
It seems like he thinks,
like this guy knows,
everyone feels the way he feels, but they won't say it.
Right. So,
and I just don't think that that's the case.
The problem is, he thinks that those people laughing in that big room are still how the entire world is,
they're not.
That to me seems like their failure as a comic, right? It's their failure to really listen to their own audience.
Woman.
Whoa.
But think about it, he thinks that everybody. What he's basically saying is, he thinks that everybody in this theater laughing thinks that's funny.
Tiny venues.
They're making this argument. He's out of touch. Yeah, I guess he's out of touch. Though, if you look at the Rotten Tomatoes critics score versus the audience, it's almost as though it's the opposite of that.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
33% from critics, 99% from the audience.
Waiting for them to remove the audience score. So,
this is
unreliable.
Yeah,
he is showing that the left is demonstrably out of touch. So you can contrast that with Hannah Gatsby's terribly unfunny Nanette special. It's got 100% on Rotten Tomatoes.
Seriously,
from the critics, panned by the public, only 40%. Did you see that's one where she goes, "There's nothing funny about self-deprecation. Self-deprecation is self-humiliation. You're a fat lesbian Australian. Self-humiliation is the only card you have to play.
That's all you got, lady. Don't take it away.
Many cards.
I say this. Humiliation is largely the only card I have to play. This is important. First off, the videos on Netflix, their YouTube, millions of plays. Usually they're getting about 25,000 plays.
Doing very, very well.
Per video. But they couldn't silence him calling him a racist because he's black. But he did the same thing that conservatives did, and that he went off the reservation, and he expressed an opinion that they don't like. Yeah. So they go, hold on a second. We have to use the same tactic that we use against conservatives to silence them. We can't say racist. I know black people can still be transphobic. Transphobe.
Yeah.
That's what they do. It's the same exact technique. They're just going to keep going down the list, and that's why appeasing crocodiles is futile. But Nanette from Hannah Gatsby, 100%. You know what else? While we're talking about out of touch, Knock Down the House, 100% from critics, 25% from the audience. But if none of this works, saying that he's a bully, saying that he's transphobic, saying that he's punching down, saying he's out of touch, what do they do? This is what the left always does with comedians. They just claim, you guess it, that he's unfunny.
He doesn't know what he's talking about. He's kind of stuck at this very basic level that he can't get past, and it's he could just not do the trans jokes because he obviously doesn't really have anything very incisive to say about it. And so it's actually, I'm just sort of embarrassed for him watching him.
Why didn't Dave Chappelle think of that?
I know.
Nothing incisive to say. Wow, just, you know, the news commentary was missing from your comedy Netflix special.
Do you mean that he just
he just needed to know that he shouldn't joke about your thing.
Right.
You used to be a man. Woman now. So just woman. Make sure.
So we're clear.
That if, I mean, it would be fine if he just didn't do the trans jokes. Oh. Is that the only rule? And then someone else says, yeah. Yes, and by the way, don't make the trans amputee jokes. And then you have somebody else going, and don't make the trans ageist jokes, because I believe that I'm a 6-year-old girl named Stephanie who screws Harley Davidson riders. And everyone says, just don't make jokes about me. And then you have Hannah Gatsby saying, don't make jokes about lesbian fat Australians who refuse to do comedy and call it a comedy special. I mean, at what point do you just admit you don't like it and move on? I'm embarrassed for him. Oh, well, I'm sure. Let's get Dave Chappelle on my landline with the speed dial. One of the most prolific comedic minds of our generation. All of a sudden, this is something that's important to note. All of a sudden, they did it with Dennis Miller, became unfunny overnight.
Right. No.
And they claim it's embarrassing. They did the same thing with Norm MacDonald.
Exactly.
Right? Norm MacDonald, Dennis Miller. They did it at one point with Bill Burr when they thought he was getting problematic. And now they're doing it with Dave Chappelle. How did he become so unfunny so quickly?
Yeah.
Is he like Jesus, where you touch his mic and he's losing his powers? They've done this with Dave Chappelle, and they've done it with us on this show. What they try to do when they say this person isn't funny, they separate the actual joke from what offends them, right? They did this with when they go, well, what Stephen Crowder claims it's jokes, but I don't think that calling someone a lispy gay Mexican is a joke. Well, that wasn't the joke. That's what offended you. The joke was, go watch the apology video. That's 20 minutes long of jokes. That's not the joke. Like with Dave Chappelle, the joke about people driving, the gays driving the car, and trans people making the ride feel like it's way longer than it needs to be. That's the joke. You were offended by the fact that he made fun of transgenders. So they say, well, I don't see the joke in making fun of transgenders. That's not the joke. You're separating what offended you from what the actual joke was. And that's why they don't want to run the clips. And here's a general rule that I use when it applies to anything, jokes or commentary, right? If you extend the clip that you see that typically generates outrage, extend it 30 seconds in either direction. It'll usually go one of two directions. If you extend it, it's either less offensive or you understand the point to it or it gets worse. For example, remember we did that joke about Christine Blasey Ford?
Yeah.
The authorities still are considering the distinct possibility that she's a lying whore was the joke.
Yeah.
Well, the Young Turks, I hate, I know we can't use them anymore once we surpass them, but that live stream is going to be a lot of fun.
Yep.
when people extended it 30 seconds in either direction, what they saw was that we used all of the evidence as the setup. And the punchline was that police officer, and people said, oh, you know what? I don't even necessarily agree, but it's really not as offensive as you make it seem. Now, if you extend it, for example, someone saying that, I don't know, I like seeing American war heroes getting killed in Iraq and we deserve 9/11, you go, oh, what's that? That sounds bad. And you extend it, and it's just them going, seriously, I effing think we deserve 9/11. Yeah. Seriously, I effing hope this guy gets taken out by jihadists. And you go, whoa, that, I provided more context. It's almost like it's worse.
Give you a little more rope.
That's a rule that I use. Separate what offends you from the actual context and content of the joke, and then whatever it is that offends you, give it more context. Give it 30 seconds in both directions, and then if at that point you're not sure, give it a minute in both directions. It's usually pretty easy to find out where they're coming from. And there is nothing sadder, while we're talking about this, than watching woke leftists explain comedy to one of the greatest comics of our time. I think that's what bothers me about this so much right now, is this sermonizing, and I hate to use the word virtue signaling. We do have to get to John O'Hurley and a little bit, Jay Peterman. Let's assume, though, that the left is being genuine. I always typically assume that they're being genuine. Let's assume that everyone is actually offended and genuinely hurt by these jokes. Okay, how about this? You don't have to find it funny. You just have to acknowledge that it's comedy. Let's start with that. Start with that, context over content, and then maybe we can find some common ground. Hey there, YouTube viewer. If you like this video, click one of these other videos playing in a box up there and hit subscribe or the notification bell if you're already subscribed so you can find out about our new non-controversial videos, which don't ruffle any feathers and, of course, are not a violation of YouTube's algorithms. Everyone's welcome here, except I don't know if we are, but it's our channel. I'm not sure how that works.